This quick traction waveform tutorial looks at how to easily export MIDI. So if you've come up with a MIDI pattern and maybe you want to load it in another DAW or another project, or maybe you just want to save it for later, this traction waveform tutorial will help. Also, you can use this to convert step clips into MIDI clips, and I'll show you how to do that too. I'm Zane. Thank you so much for checking out this Simple Green Tech video. And just so you know, I'm using Traction Waveform 11 Pro for this video, but you can do this in Waveform Free and older versions of Waveform as well. So let's dive in. All right, first I want to note that this does not save the sound of your VST instrument. It only saves the MIDI information so you can load it into another DAW or another project and add it to whatever VST that you want. Or you can use this to easily send your MIDI to another band member or someone you're collaborating with. So you're not sending the sounds that this is making, you're just sending the MIDI information, which is all of these notes in here. To just export a regular MIDI clip, what we want to do is to click on our MIDI clip like this, and then we're going to go down to Export, click on Render to a File, and then when this render window opens up, click here where it says Format and change it to MIDI. And now we have some options. So you have only render marked region. So if you have a marked region like I do here, I have the start and the end, and you had more stuff in your project that could possibly be rendered, but you only want what's in the marked region, then you want to select that. If you want everything, even what's outside of the marked region, leave that unchecked. Now you have only render selected clips. So I have this clip selected, so we would only render this. But if you had a whole track full of clips, and I'll show you right now. So if you had a track that was full of a bunch of clips, like say maybe one's verse, chorus, something else, or you just had a bunch of small regions that loop, and you want to save all of this into one file, then you want to make sure that's all selected. And an easy way to do that is click on the first one, then hold down Shift on your computer keyboard and click on the last one. And now you can see it's selected all of them. And then we can go back into the export render to a file. So if you wanted all of that, you could leave only render selected clips checked. But if you had a bunch of clips and you wanted them all rendered, then you could uncheck this. And then you might want to do render each track to a separate file. So if you had more tracks that had MIDI on it and you wanted each one to be rendered to a separate file, you would check that. And then you have this over here. This is the pass-through plugins. And you'll notice when I hover over top of it, you can see that it now says, note that many plugins will swallow any MIDI data that passes into them. So if you leave this checked, you're actually not going to get any MIDI out. Possibly. Most of the time I've found that you don't get MIDI out. So just leave this unchecked. Then there's also this render at 1x play speed. And this is just in case your computer has some problems with rendering quickly. So I suggest leaving this unchecked. If you have no problems, then there's nothing to worry about. If you find that you have problems, then go back and check this. Then the next thing you might want to do is go up to these dots here, click on it, click Browse, and then select a place to save your new MIDI clip. And you can also give it a name in here. So I'm going to give this a name. Click Save. And now we're ready to render this. So we would just click Render. And it was that quick. So depending on how much MIDI data you're going to be rendering, it could be quick like that, or it could take a little bit longer. Now let's look at that MIDI clip that we just rendered. So I'm going to open it up into FL Studio just to show you it's the exact same clip, but we're just changing DAWs. So we go up to File, Import, MIDI file. There's my piano clip. Now I just drag it into here, double click, and there is our MIDI clip that we just rendered. And you can see all of the velocity data and everything's still in there. Everything's the same. It's the exact same MIDI clip. So all we would have to do is just insert a piano plugin and we can play it back. And there you go. So like I said earlier, another use for this could be changing step clips into MIDI clips. And one of the great things about working with a step clip is that they allow you to easily create drum patterns. But you may eventually want to have that pattern in the piano roll for editing later, or again to send to someone else or use it in a different DAW. So let's look at converting a step clip into a MIDI clip. So I'm just going to drag a new step clip down into here. And you can see we have bass drum, so I'll put a bass, snare, bass, snare, nothing fancy here. And then we'll just put some hi-hats in here. All right, so that's our step clip there. And one thing you'll notice when you create one bar in a step clip is that it actually repeats it. So if you want all of this, all four of these bars here, not just the one, then make sure you have the whole region selected here like this by moving your marked region markers up at the top here. Then we'll just export it like we did before. So we click export, render to a file, make sure your format is a MIDI file. And then you want the only render marked region, which is this region here. And you also want to render each track to a separate file because we do have two tracks here and I don't have any of them selected. So this time it's actually going to render both of these tracks to separate files. And that's all we need to worry about for the settings. I'll just change where I'm going to save it, then click render. And you can see on my desktop here, I have two patterns that it saved. So it has track one, which would be that piano pattern from before, and then track two, which is our drum clip. And I'm going to load that into FL Studio again. Here's our drum pattern that I just created in that step clip in waveform. So what we'll need to do in here is just add a drum plugin like the FPC that comes with FL Studio. And now we'll listen. Well, that's the drum beat that I came up with. I wasn't really listening to it. I was just showing for an example. And if you want to check out even more Traction Waveform tutorials from me, click up here or click down here to see what YouTube recommends. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching for Simple Green Tech. I'm Zane. Keep creating and we'll talk soon.